So what kind of presentation you are now doing? Presentations are of different type. What type of presentation you are doing now? Graphical presentation. Graphical presentation you are doing in that two types of presentation, time series and presentation of frequency. So in that you have seen the frequency polygon and what is the thing? Cumulative frequency graph. Under cumulative frequency graph, we have seen less than ogive and more than ogive. Okay, so I will give you one more question for this less than and more than. Then afterwards, we will do the revision of this chart. Okay, so write the question. Draw. Less than ogive curve. Draw less than ogive curve and more than ogive curve on the basis of data given below. On the basis of data given below. So you have to do, so previously the previous question you have done less than separate and more than separate. This question you will do in the same graph because it is the same graph is given and you are asked to draw both the less than ogive curve and more than ogive curve in the same graph you will draw. Okay, and the data, write the data, marks. 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, till 60. Then, number of students, that is frequency, number of students, 7, 10, 14, 20, 6, and 3. I will write it on the board if you want. I will read once again. Let me. So, the number of students. Can you see my board?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Here, we will write the marks. Marks I have given you. And the frequency. Frequencies I have given the number of students. And the number of students. What are the number of students? 7. 10. Then 14. 20, 6, and 3. 20, 6, and 3. So these are the number of students. So you have to draw in the same ogive, less than and more than. Start doing it. First of all, you have to convert the data into a less than series and more than series and do it. So the marks were like this. I will write the question here. You continue with the answer. You proceed. Is Chaitanya present? Is Chaitanya present?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
No. So you have to change this question into less than series and more than series. When you change it into less than, you will get a less than ogive curve. And when you change it into a more than series, you will get a more than ogive curve. Yeah, read the frequencies of the less than ogive. Sorry, read the less than series.
Seven.
Read it like this, less than 10, 7, like that you read.
Less than 10, 7. Less than 20, 17. Less than
31. Less than 30?
31.
Less than 14.
Less than 14, 62.
Sorry?
Ma'am, 62.
Ma'am, 51.
51.
31 plus 20, na?
51.
51. And next?
57.
57.
57, then 60.
60.
60.
So what is the total frequency?
60.
60. So this is the less than series. Now coming to the more than series, how will it go? More than 10 or 0? More than?
0.
0.
0. You have to take the lower limit. Then more than?
10.
20. 30.
40 and
till what I have to write? 30,
50,
40, sorry?
Till 50, ma'am.
Till 50 only 50. I have to write, because you have only the series 50 to 60. So more than 50 will come. Here 50 to 60, more than 50 will come. And here in the more than series, more than 0 means all these numbers till 60 is more than 0. Isn't it? Till 60 is more than 0. So the total frequency will come here. That is 6 plus 3, 18, 38, 42, 52. Yeah. 72, not 72. 6, 17, 21, 31, 55, 57, 60. So the total frequency will come at the beginning, because more than 60 means the whole frequency, the total will come. Yeah, then here what will come? Here you write series, the heading. 53. Here you will write series.
53.
And here you will write cumulative frequency. So here what will come?
53.
53.
Is it 53?
Yes, ma'am.
And here?
43.
43.
43. Here?
29.
29. 29. That means 43 minus 14. After that?
9.
9. Then?
3.
9 minus 3, 9 minus 6, that is 3. So you have made the less than series and the more than series. Now this less than series and more than series, you have to draw in a graph, in the same graph. The same graph, you have to do the less than series and the more than series. Did it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Then 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60. So what you have taken in the x-axis, 5, 10, 15, yeah, 10, 15, 10, 20. What you have taken in the y-axis?
Ma'am, 10, 20.
Okay. So in the less than OGF series, plan 0 to 10. The frequency is 7. 0 to 10. Frequency is 7. So somewhere here it will come. Somewhere here. That means below 10. Okay. Below 10. And the next class is 10 to 20, 17. So here, you just write the numbers what you have determined, selected like 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Here, write the numbers and here also. Write the numbers. So this is 0 to 10. Then 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, and 50 to 60. Classes are here. And the next is 17 here. And then 31. After 17, what? 31. Where is 31? Yeah, 31 here. Okay. Then 57 here, 57. After that, after both 60. So your card will go like this. Is the shape? Sorry, is it the shape you got? So this is the shape you will get, and it will go up like this. And the next, we will start with 60 from here, right? The first class will start with 60, with 53. Then 43, then 29, then what is this 9? Then it is 9, and then it is 3. It is 3. So the next OGF will come like this. So this is here you write less than OGF, you have to name it. And here you write more than Jai. More than Jai. Name it. This is the less than, which is starting with the least frequency. And this is the more than Jai, which is starting with the maximum frequency. And here you can see an intersection point. And this intersection point is actually the median. Find out in your book at what particular value it comes. Find it out which particular value. Mine will not be that correct because I haven't done an exact measurement. Yours will be correct. What is the value you get here, the intersection point?
30.
I'm 30.
30. Okay. Yes. So what is the median? The median is equal to 30. The median is equal to 30. So by drawing the less than OGF and the more than OGF in the same graph, you can find out the median also. This is one of the methods to find out the median. One of the easiest methods through graphical representation, how will you find median? So now it has come in the exact measurement. Sometimes it may come in between this or in between this and all. So now you In this case, you got the exact measurement. Even I got the exact measurement, 0, 10, 20, 30. Okay, so median is 30. The intersection of the less than ogive and the more than ogive. What is median? The median is the middlemost value of the item. Yes or no? The meaning of median. Median is the middlemost value of an of a series. The middlemost item. So that is median. So here it comes at 30. That is why it is intersecting here. Okay. So this is how you make the less than ogive and the more than ogive. So that is all with the graphical representation. So in this lesson, the presentation of data. What is the lesson? The name of the lesson? Name of the lesson we are doing with. What is the name of the lesson? Presentation of?
Presentation of data.
In presentation of data. Here you have studied textual presentation. Yeah, come on. Textual presentation. Then?
Tabular presentation.
Next?
Diagrammatic
representation and graphical representation. So this much we have studied four important types of representation we have studied in the presentation of data. You know what is textual and tabular, diagrammatic. Now we were doing with the graphic presentation. So in the graphic presentation, in detail, we have studied how to make a frequency polygon and the less than ogive and the more than ogive. So here, this chapter is over. We will make a revision with the help of the class edge. Can you see my class edge? Class edge board. So what?
No, ma'am.
You are still in the board, right? Okay, let me. Are you still in the board?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I will come. I will stop this. Come to the meet. Again, I will present. Then, classes. Now?
Yes, ma'am.
So we will see the graphic presentation. So here you have a revision, see whatever the things you have seen. So summary of that.
Collection, organization, and presentation of data. Presentation.
Listen carefully and answer to the questions.
Collection of data. Introduction. This topic covers importance of data presentation, different forms of data presentation, advantages and disadvantages of each form of data presentation. Presentation of data. When data.
What is presentation of data, anyone? You know what is presentation of data. What is presentation? Meaning of presentation. Vaishnavi, what is the meaning of presentation?
Presenting the data in the most beautiful manner.
Yeah, attractive or understandable manner is known as the presentation of data. Okay.
That has been collected is visually represented. It is referred to as presentation of data. Presentation of data begins after the collection and organization of data. Data could be represented in the following formats: textual, tabular, graphical.
So what is being skipped from here? We have seen four types. What is being not, what is not given here?
Diagrammatic.
So diagrammatical and graphical, there are so many same measures are there. When it is done in the graph, so it is graphical. That's why here only three are given. Okay.
Tabular presentation. A table is a systematic presentation of data in rows and columns. It helps in simplification of data, facilitating comparison, easy detection of errors. In this table, the information is given in a tabular form. The table is divided into class and frequency. Components of a table. Components of a table and their significance. 1. Table number. 2. Title. Brief, clear, and self-explanatory. 3. Head note, which indicates the measurement unit. 4. Caption, which indicates the heading of the vertical column. 5. Stub head, which indicates the heading of the horizontal rows. 6. Body, which indicates the statistical data in the form of numbers. 7. Footnote, which explains some special items or features of the table. 8. Source, which shows the place from where the data has been taken.
Kanak?
Yes, ma'am.
Read the components of table. Read the different components, yes. 8 components. Only read the names.
Table number, title, head notes, caption, stub head, body, footnote, source.
And source. See, table number is given here. See at the right side, table number. So these are the important components of a table. Without giving a name here, table number here, title here, you write something in the rows and column, it will not be considered as a proper table. So table number should be given. Then after that, the title should be given, just like marks of 10-20 students of class 11B. Like that, some title should be given. So first of all, table number, then title. Afterwards, what is their head note? Unit of measurement. Suppose it is coming in hundreds, thousands, or like that. Some head note should be there. Head note is nothing else, some notes. Notes which help you to read this. Okay? Head note will be, we have it like in thousand in crores and like that. You can give a note here. Then afterwards, there is caption. Caption means this heading, that heading of the vertical column. So this vertical column has a heading that is known as caption. So this vertical columns, the heading of that is known as caption. And what is stub head? Stub head is this, okay, which indicate the heading of the horizontal rows. So these rows also have a heading that is known as stub head. These rows also have a heading that is known as stub head. Then come the body. Body means whatever numerical data you write here, like 10 to 20, 20 to 30 or whatever, or frequency, whatever you write here, that is known as the body. Then footnote. In the footnote, some note can be given to make this more understandable. And source, like from where you have taken this. So that is, these are the important components of our table. You can write these 8 components. Table number, title, head note, caption, stub head, body, footnote, and source. In this, here you should see, what is caption? Caption is the heading of the vertical column.
Types of tabular presentation. Components of a table. Components of a table and their significance.
Caption
1.
Is the
table number. 2. Title. Brief, clear, and self-explanatory. 3. Head note, which indicates the measurement unit. 4. Caption, which indicates the heading of the vertical column. 5. Stub head, which indicates the heading of the horizontal rows. 6. Body, which indicates the statistical data in the form of numbers. 7. Footnote, which explains some special items or features of the table. 8. Source, which shows the place from where the data has been taken.
So now are you clear with the terms? What is caption? What is subhead and all? All the other things you can understand. What is title, headnote and all, you know. But here you don't get confused between caption and subhead. Subhead is the heading for this, okay, this row, and caption is the heading for the column. That you remember. You can take a screenshot as well. Okay, so can we move to the next? No.
Yes, ma'am.
Types of tabular presentation. Univariate table. This type of table shows a single variable. In this table, there is an explanation about one variable, country. Bivariate table. This type of table shows two interrelated characteristics. In this table, there are two variables, age group, which is an independent variable, and number of students, which is a dependent variable. The characteristics are based on the gender, boys, girls. Manifold table. This type of table shows several variables with common characteristics. In this table, the variables are tabular presentation, graphical presentation. Graphical presentation involves a visual representation of statistical data. There are two types of graphical representation, frequency data and non-frequency data. The frequency data is further classified into histogram, frequency polygon, frequency curve, and ogive. The non-frequency data is further classified into the line diagram, bar diagram, and pie diagram. Histogram. A histogram is a two-dimensional graphical representation of a grouped frequency distribution by means of adjacent rectangles. Each class interval represents the width of a histogram. The frequency of each class interval represents the height of a histogram. Example:
so what is a histogram? Somehow read what is a histogram. What do you mean by a histogram? Sambhav Jain, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Read what is a histogram.
A histogram is a two-dimensional graphical representation of a grouped frequency distribution by means of adjacent rectangles.
By means of what? Adjacent rectangles. It's a two-dimensional graphical representation of a frequency distribution through the help of adjacent rectangles.
Frequency polygon. A frequency polygon is obtained by joining the midpoints at the top of the vertical bars of a histogram using straight lines. It helps to compare data by displaying cumulative frequency distribution. Example: the frequency is given in this table. The cumulative frequency distribution is calculated by adding all the frequencies.
See, what is a frequency polygon? You have done it. So here you have a midpoint, and this midpoint is joined with the help of a straight line. This line is known as the frequency. This particular representation is known as the frequency polygon.
Frequency curve. A frequency curve is obtained by joining the midpoints of the class interval at their respective frequencies with the help of a smooth curve. It indicates the rate of rise and fall of frequencies. Example:
so what is the difference between a frequency polygon and a frequency curve? Difference between a frequency
polygon.
Come on, speak.
frequency polygon, the line, the points are joined with a straight line, and in frequency curve, the points are joined with a smooth curve.
And the drawing a histogram and the rectangles, it is your like a, you don't want to make that. You just find out the midpoint.
Ogive. Ogive is a graphical representation of cumulative frequencies less than any upper class boundary or more than any lower class boundary. There are two types of ogive curves. They are less than ogive and more than ogive. Less than ogive. The curve is plotted from the lowest cumulative frequency. The slope of the curve moves upwards. More than ogive. The curve is plotted from the highest cumulative frequency. The slope of the curve moves downwards. Less than ogive. How to construct a less than ogive? Draw and label the x-axis and y-axis. Take the cumulative frequencies along the y-axis and upper class limit on the x-axis. Plot the cumulative frequencies against the upper class limit. Join the points to form a curve. Example.
This is the less than ogive. So you have done this less than ogive.
Line diagram. A line diagram is obtained by joining the points, the midpoints of the class interval. It shows the relationship between the two variables on the x-axis and the y-axis. Bar diagram. A bar diagram is the graphical representation of data in the form of equal bars. It is used to compare qualitative and quantitative data. There are five types of bar diagram: simple bar diagram, multiple bar diagram, subdivided bar diagram, percentage bar diagram, and deviation bar. Simple bar diagram.
So this you have seen.
Subdivided bar diagram. A subdivided bar diagram.
The subdivided bar diagram you haven't done. In this, the same bar is subdivided into many components. See, the same bar is subdivided. See here, this is a mark obtained by a student. So English is depicted by blue color, it is given in the blue color, economics in green color, accounts in orange, and blue with computer science with blue. So that is why it is subdivided. The same bar is divided into many parts, that is why it's subdivided bar diagram. This represents various part of the whole bar in proportion to the given value. So in what proportion it is? This is the total marks of that according to the proportion. It will be divided. That is subdivided bar diagram.
Percentage bar diagram. Deviation bar pi diagram. A pi diagram is a graphical representation of various components in a circle. The circle is divided into various parts with the help of straight lines. The surface area of the circle covers 360 degrees. The total frequencies are equated to 360 degrees and then the angles corresponding to component parts are calculated. How to construct a pi diagram? The following formula is used to convert the value of the components into degrees. Value of component upon total value into 360 degree. The angles determined are used to draw the required sectors in the circle.
You remember this calculation? You have to change every angle into the form of 360. The total frequency will come here. The concerned frequency will come here into 360. Do you remember this calculation? By making a pie chart? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Example. Pie diagram of the expenses incurred by a manufacturing unit.
See, this is the pie diagram. very easily understandable. This is 25% is of what? Tell me, after looking at this, tell me 25% belongs to what?
Paper cost.
25% for?
Paper cost.
Paper cost. And this 20% for? Binding. And 15% is for royalty. So it is very very much understandable. This 10% is for promotion cost. 20% is for what? Printing cost. 10% is for transportation cost. So that is the beauty of the pie diagram. It is given in a very understandable manner. And see this calculation. And very important question in the exam also. See the pie diagram, how nicely it is given. Binding 20, royalty 15. So you have to change it to different angles. That is 20 by total frequency into 360. 15 by total frequency into 360. 10 by 100 into 360. Likewise, it has been changed and it is depicted inside the 360 degree by giving different colors. And you can even buy different designs also. So that is pie
graphical diagram. Representation. Advantages. A quick recap. Graphical representation. Advantages. Easy to understand. Visually appealing. Possibility of comparing two or more variables. Easy to draw a conclusion. Disadvantages. No detailed statistical information. Time consuming. Possibility of a wrong calculation.
So see the advantages and disadvantages. Advantages, it is very easy to understand. You have seen the pie diagram and visually appealing. So it is attractively given. It's given in an attractive manner. And possibility of comparing two or more variables there. You can compare with 10%, 50%. So there's comparing two or more variables. Easy to draw conclusions also. And disadvantages, it is time consuming to make. Possibility of wrong calculation. So see, if the calculation itself is wrong, the whole thing what you depict in the graph, that will be wrong. So no detailed statistical information. These are the disadvantages. Okay. So that was a revision. Okay, Purvi? That was the revision of presentation of data. Rekha?